And then more in line of what I plan on doing for the larger rafter is this style sheath. Still a like three-piece construction. But the point of it is the sheath. So the front part of the sheath is essentially this footprint with this portion that folds back over the pole. Now there's no cutting edge here, so we don't need to worry about a welt here. There's a cutting edge here, so that's why I did worry about a welt here. Obviously the bottom of the beard's not a cutting edge, but again, adding that thickness prevents that leather from needing to stretch, you know. When you're looking in there, that leather's got to stretch out and around. So adding that little bit of extra thickness in there with the welt does help. Let's see, another example. This one has the snap on the bottom, right? This is a old sheath that I got with, I think it was the Plum Boys Axe. So, yeah, essentially I'm just trying to replicate this style sheath before this rafter that I want to keep in the truck, so.
So the sheath for the plumb rafter is done. We're outside, so I apologize if you guys get some road noise from the road out there. But yeah, plumb rafter's done, sheath's all done. Happy with our mask. Still not sure where exactly it is, but happy with how it came out. Darkened up nicely with that oil. Looks really good. I'm happy with the color. It's kind of that, like, it's almost like an ox bloody wine tone, but that kind of some brown hues to it. So I think it looks cool. I think it matches the plum, you know, plum theme, I guess. But I figured I'd give you some shots of the axe all done in actual good daylight. So it's done. Happy with it. Happy with how that heartwood's looking. Again, super nice grain orientation. Zero run out. Really happy with this handle. So okay, give it some shots. Let's watch this while we're out here. Try to not knock over the camera.